I've needed a good healthy reason to change. Day after day with no direction. Revealing yourself differently here with you. Not pain but excitement, a curious infection. Will I repeatedly give in to the doubt? Will I scale this mountain and shout? Forgetting that courage is measured in jars, defined by your choices, mistakes, and scars. I'll see you through hard times. Don't run, I've got hope. I'm always on fire, but your heart may be my water. With one headlight. 1, 2, 3, 4. Forget these songs. And though I'm young, life's been short, I'm only 21. one. I feel as if we can lay on some of these words I've written down. So turn off this song. Find someone to love. Turn off this song. You can listen to it later. Shirts and $100 pants. Often think we do what no one can. We see ourselves above the rest. When faced with truth, I realize there is nothing I can do. Amount of talent or gift to bring that is greater than the orphan or song she sings. Turn off this song. Find someone to love.
You guys, first of all, thank you so much.
Sounds good.
Oh, good. That's good. thank you for taking the time, for spending the money, for finding babysitters and all the things that you had to do to get here. There's some things I wanted to say. First of all, I just want to thank somebody. I want to thank Brent, who's here with his camera, Brent Driscoll. He made this happen by force of will, and I've been swept up in his will. This is something I was like, yeah, we can do that. And then as it's gone along and I've prepped, I've realized it's something I've wanted to do for a very long time. It's kind of a bucket list thing of mine, so thank you.
Ooh.
can find an ally. But in the meantime, it's like lifting up your voice in an empty arena. Yeah, yeah, step away from the pain. It is gonna change. You can wait for light in the morning. Step away from the pain. Thank you guys so much. Thank you.
simple words I try to tell. You are the water, I'm the well.
Thank you. So, we've got some pretty special people playing with us, playing with me, playing with us, wow. Corey on cello. Yep. Maria on viola. Alina on violin. And Andrew on violin. Known collectively as the Passenger String Quartet. Andrew, thank you for all of your beautiful compositions on this. So let's give Andrew a round of applause.
So now's the time when we have a little bit of a Q&A. I did a thing, we did a thing, Sessions in Place. We put some link out there, NGL, and not gonna lie, so it's anonymous. Hey, hey. And here is some questions that have been gathered. On the realm of stories of songs, what's the story behind Give Back My Heart?
That song is about breaking up with cultural Christianity. For real. Yeah, there's a song, a very well-known Christian song that uses the term reckless. And I thought I would write a song where I used the term in a way that seemed fitting to me. So that's where the give back that piece of my heart you took so recklessly. I'm on my knees begging for release. Sing into cultural Christianity.
Beautiful, beautiful. Nice. We got some fanfare from that. And somehow moving right along, what's the weirdest trend that you've been involved in?
I have forever been out of step with trends. For real, I've like failed miserably at being part of trends. I think I've tried and just never figured it out.
Okay, how about one thing you cannot survive without? I guess, also, he might need some more wine. He just finished his cup of wine. Okay, he can survive without wine.
I mean, I can answer... I can give the really big zoomed out answer and the really small answer. The small one is obviously my white noise machine. I need that when I travel. And I think the big zoomed out one is, I mean, my partner and wife, Anna Babe. I can't survive without her. And yeah. Yep. And, you know, most of you know I'm a Christian, so obviously I feel deeply that I can't survive without my faith, so.
Beautiful. How about, what was the song that was the hardest to write? And how about the song that was the easiest to write?
I think the easiest song I've written is a song called All Shall Be Well, and I wrote it really quickly. It took about 10 minutes. And the hardest song I've written is a song called Absentee Heartbeat.
We got someone to agree to that one. That was the easiest song for you to write. So, does anyone have any burning questions for Mr. John Van Deusen? I am going to walk out there and put a mic in your face. Do not touch it. I'm going to put it right in your face. All right, I see one. I'm going. Here we go.
Hi, John. Huge fan. Did you ever clean the stuff off your guitar neck?
I did. Thank you.
What did you use?
Don't remember. Goo Gone? It wasn't essential oil, maybe both?
Goo Gone? Was it Goo Gone?
I don't know.
Okay.
I think so.
Thank you. You've been very helpful.
Thank you.
Anyone else? Okay. Oh, here we go.
Okay. Don't touch your mic. John, have you ever sang with the choir, and is that something you ever think about doing?
Who is that?
It's Jeremiah from Anacortes.
Hi, Jeremiah. I've never sang with a choir. Well, no, that's not true. I sang once with a boy choir, the Bay Area, maybe Oakland boy choir. That was fantastic. So I guess I have, not very often have I sung with a choir, but
well,
it
just
sounds...
This arrangement tonight sounds so awesome. I think a whole orchestra behind you would be just as awesome. Choir, the whole deal, it's awesome.
Yeah, sounds expensive. Yeah, you want to bankroll that? I'll gladly do it. Yeah. But for real, thank you. That means a lot to me. I would definitely enjoy doing that, so.
Yes, yes, yes. Any other questions? Okay, I'm going to just wiggle, sorry, pardon. Oh, someone dropped a drink. Here we go. Please say your name. That would be something great to say at the top.
My name is Sarah. How do you feel that becoming a parent has changed you as an artist?
Well, I mean, it's definitely changed me as a person. Slowly kind of sucks the selfishness out of you a bit, and you feel like, you know, part of your heart's walking around in this little person. I think about the future more and how the story of my songs will one day be like digested by this person when they grow up. And so I think it's just changed me a little bit in knowing that someday I might have to talk him through the stories and the words. And I don't know, it just changes, it adds more weight to what you do. So I don't really know how else to say it, but I've written songs for him and about him, and that obviously is one thing that has changed. So I don't feel like that was the greatest answer. But yeah, that's what I've got.
Did that satisfy? Did that answer satisfy? Okay, you got an okay.
Hey, I'm Chris. I had a question, and then as a recent father, that one really struck me. But so I'm a little distracted, and I forgot my question. But I think it was, what's your favorite and least favorite songs to sing over and over, I guess?
Wow. My favorite and least favorite, you said? Some of the songs, a lot of the songs I've written come from pretty vulnerable places, especially the old ones. You know, I'll be the first one to say that I think my late teens and 20s, I was a fairly chaotic mess, and I wrote a lot of songs. And so I think singing some of those songs is kind of like reliving them a little bit, reliving the moments. I don't enjoy that all the time, but I do it because it's important to remember, but also I know others connect with the songs, and so I want to, you know, play them. You said the easiest song, right? I think the songs that I'd call worship are probably the easiest. They're the most life-giving, and like, you know, I'm singing about something bigger and beyond myself. So, yeah. This song is called Patient Saint, and it's about my partner, Anna Babe. I should thank her. Anna Babe has chosen to, you know, forgive me and love me through so much. And yeah, I definitely wouldn't be here without her. So love you, Anna Babe, a lot. Song's for her. I found all the photos of you in your wedding dress, spinning around at the Pemberton gym. No makeup or flowers or anyone else, just you being you in your own way. I still recall June, when we told the world what we planned to do. My hair thinned when my sister spoke. I realized I'd lost the popular vote. My God, how I took you for granted. Harvest pain that I've planted, and with the patience of a saint, you wait. You should have thrown me out like a cigarette. Burnt out and used and crushed underfoot. Instead, you opened your generous arms, told me you believed that I could become someone. And my God, how I took you for granted. Still harvest pain that I've planted. And with the patience of a saint, you wait. I love you more every day. 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 Thank you. I love watching you run and hearing you sing, seeing you see your sweet golden night spring. Dirt under nails and the grass on your knees, wind in your sails on imagined seas. Hold on, my boy, you know we're spinning 1,000 miles per hour. Gravity pulling our rock into space, forever embracing the starry-tongued face of infinity. And they'll tell you that wisdom is belief in self, force feed you the dollar and bastardized health. So run from their ethics and flee from their waste. Turn from your screen and find sun on your face. Hold on, my boy, there are beginnings in every form of ending. So don't tarry so long in the modernist crazy, but fly for the love light, perpetually breaking for infinity. For absentee heartbeat, it's all we have to go on. The look on their faces told me that you were gone. And there go all the things we planned,
just get up older. Well, I guess that you've been saved the weight of growing up and breaking down. And your tiny body sleeps under the holly tree. And your mom planted flowers so you wouldn't get lonely. And there go all the things we planned. All the things we planned. There go all the things we planned for you. And there go all the things we planned. All the things we planned. There go all the things we planned for you. Absentee heartbeat, it's all we have to go on. The look on their faces told me that you.
Thank you.
Please. open my eyes deep in the night to cough rolling thunder. And there's smoke on my tongue and I'm no longer young. I visit the river to cool off my mind under the rhyme. Sweet blueberry shiver. And I'm overanalyzing every bloody thing. King of nothing more than words that fail to bring meaning to my life. I could use a little cabin in the woods, watch some birds and maybe smoke away the shoulds. Perhaps then I'll find some quiet. No more car alarms, crowded subway cars, indoor cigarettes, pressure on my chest. No more mystery meets, suicidal streets, vomit by the door, sticky bags.
See if I can do it. together, we share our father's sin. I am afraid of myself in the darkness that's rising inside of my heart. So I hope I can trust you, 'cause I know I can't trust myself. Open my eyes, remove anything in the way, and please be all I need, be everything. Walking away from the water, I felt that a weight had been lifted. You shone through the clouds, and one day when I have a boy and I can't keep this from him, his father sin, no, I will try and trust you, 'cause I know I can trust myself. Open my eyes, remove anything in the I saw my mom in the line for the bathroom, and she's like, you should do this all the time. Thanks, Mom. I'm trying to use Oliver's tuner here and failing miserably. So I've been telling people this last week. A few weird things have happened to me as I've been preparing for this show. First of all, I had this realization that I no longer see myself as young. And it's some cosmic spiritual thing that I've just decided, like, oh, I just think I'm ready to be an adult. I feel like a grown-up for the first time in my life, which is weird because I turn 35 next month. And this show I've been describing, it feels like a wedding and a funeral. It doesn't really feel like a show, because here I am singing all these old songs, and I've been pondering my past quite a bit, and just being really thankful for the fact that I get to be here right now. And this show, in a way, I've said, also feels like I'm shedding my skin, letting go of who I was, and trying to live into something healthier and better and an adult. And I know you all can relate on some level. And so I don't have my wine anymore. I was going to toast. But for real, it just it's a good thing to take stock of our past, but it's also a good thing to forgive, to ask for forgiveness, to seek healing, and to try to be a peacemaker in the world. And so, anyways, I don't feel like I'm describing what's in my heart very well, but the point is, this show's really monumental for me. It feels like a shedding of skin. I'm moving on. I feel like I'm moving on. That's why it feels like a funeral and a wedding at the same time. I'm on to something better. So thank you for being here. Thank you for sharing it with me. If I had a glass of wine, I'd toast, you know, to like growing up and to changing and becoming healthier. So to that, right? So. going to sing two more. I wrote this song when I was maybe 18, possibly 19. I was sitting on a rock on Little Cranberry Lake near my house, and I was observing the excavators taking down trees. I could see them tearing down trees, and I could see holes through the trees where there used to not be anything but forest. And it just made me sad. And so I, in my teenage angst, wrote this weird song about all the things that were making me angry and how I wanted to hope for something better. And it's interesting because the song after it is also about hoping for something better. So I did want to dedicate this song to my good friends, Braydn, Eric, and Tony, who have played this song with me so many times. And are just a huge part of the story with me. Oh, the wine. Thanks. I just needed it to toast. To growing up, eh? To becoming peacemakers. Thanks. The song's called We Sing in Time.
Body electric until machine and soul are one. I've seen the tweaker struggle, syringes lined to his floor. A cycle turned to life, be dead in jobs in a government's war. Oh, in time the trees die and light will fade, but I'll trample through woods and dirt they feed. What sort of world and plight for our children must we lead? Let us burn the nation's budget. Let's send boys overseas to fight ghosts in the desert instead of teaching them to give and lead. Oh, in time the trees die and life will fade, but I'll pull a new breath, a new life to take me away. Oh, in time the trees die and life will fade, but I'll pull a new breath, a new life to take me away. It's time!
Thank you for the moon. Thank you for the stars at night and the darkness too. Bless you for your peace. Bless you for your grace. Bless you for your perfect love and your perfect ways. And all shall be well. All shall be well. All manner of things shall be well. And all shall be well. All shall be well. All manner of things shall be well. Use me as you will. Remove my selfish pride. Create in me a servant's heart to bless your holy bride. And when my work is done and the seeds are sown, please receive Spirit, Lord, and welcome me home. And all shall be well. All shall be well. All manner of things shall be well. And all shall be well. All shall be well. All write a song about a man with no arms. All he had to give me was his name. Unfortunately, I couldn't speak his native tongue, and so we shared some silence in the rain. Yeah, if I give him money, will his arms grow back? Will my well-intentioned rambling ease the slack? And if I promise to pray day after day, will his pain go away? Yeah, seriously, what can I say? Honestly, what can I sing? When morning after morning, Oslo is in the rain. Yes, so I thought up some lines, it seemed insightful and strong. Yes, the wit is dripping from my lips, but damned if I can't manage to overcome advantage. My pride is swaying narcissistic hips. Yeah, if I give him money, will his arms grow back? Will my well-intentioned rambling ease the slack? And if I promise to pray day after day, will his pain go away? Yeah, seriously, what can I say? Honestly, what can I sing? When morning after morning, Oslo is. When morning after morning, Oslo is. When morning after morning, Oslo is in the rain. Yes, Oslo, as things go, you've been dealt a crippling blow, I know. So be warm, be safe. Full of grace, be warm, be safe, be full of grace, be warm, be safe, be full of grace. So be warm, be safe, be and full of grace, be warm, be safe, be. Thank you. Thank you.